And hello from New York. I'm Lisa McRee.
And I'm Aaron Brown. And in the news at this hour, the man who negotiated the end of the Vietnam War denies American servicemen were knowingly left behind. The president circles Arkansas in a day-long attack on the record of its governor, while Bill Clinton goes to Michigan looking for a debate. And Denmark agrees to a second look at the European Unity Treaty coming up later in the half hour. We'll go to Michigan for a town meeting that was supposed to be a presidential debate. And then there's parking for a penny. All of that coming up in the next half hour. But Lisa starts it off. Now your papers went flying through my face there for a second. That happens.
Sometimes. Stopping the news this morning. The ghost of the Vietnam War, which have hovered over the presidential campaign this year, touched off a heated round of testimony on Capitol Hill yesterday. In day two of hearings on the fate of Americans missing since the war, the man who negotiated the end of that war was the witness. It was an angry Henry Kissinger who took issue with charges made the previous day by his former colleagues in the Nixon administration. ABC's James Walker has the story.
A feisty Henry Kissinger vehemently denied accusations the Nixon administration had knowingly left behind American servicemen in order to end the war in Vietnam.
That allegation is a flat-out lie.
Kissinger said he realized during the peace talks the North Vietnamese had not provided a full accounting of missing Americans. He said his bargaining leverage had been undercut in part by anti-war demonstrators. Among them, Lieutenant John Kerry. Kerry returned from combat in Vietnam and testified before Congress. Now he is the committee chairman.
You suggest to me that those who opposed the war somehow took away options from you.
I don't happen to believe that this dialogue is very helpful because it refights the Vietnam War.
Checking the weather now, fall officially began yesterday afternoon. Fall weather, though, arrives today in the Northeast and the Great Lakes, where temperatures will dive into the 30s and 40s this morning. Showers and thunderstorms will continue to plague the Gulf Coast. Rain is also likely over the Northwest. A look now around Oklahoma as we check the forecast.
News Now Weather, brought to you by Nissan.
Okay, we'll try and keep this as simple as possible. You may want to take notes, however. An unusual and complicated basketball trade involving three teams, six players, and three, count them, three NBA draft picks was finalized yesterday. The new Clippers, that's the Los Angeles Clippers, are center Stanley Roberts and point guard Mark Jackson. The new New York Knicks are forwards Charles Smith and guard Doc Rivers and Bo Kimball. And the Orlando Magic gets two number one draft picks. And because of all these new Knicks, the Knicks decided they no longer needed guard Gerald Wilkins, so they dropped him. Got it? American League East is now in its final lap. The three-game series between the first-place Toronto Blue Jays and the struggling Baltimore Orioles will probably decide the outcome of the division. Last night, the two teams played in Game 1 of their series at the stadium in Baltimore. Here we go. After a three-hour rain delay, top of the fourth, John Olerud, right, say it with me, from Bellevue, Washington. A massive home run there, and it's 3-1 Blue Jays. Brady Anderson gets nailed at the plate here in a one-run ball game. And one more time in the ninth, Mark McLemore dumps it into center field. He does. Should Tim Hewlett try and score on this play, you make the call. Too late. He doesn't try and score, and the Orioles get no other chances to score. They lose 4-3 to the Blue Jays. Kirby Puckett faces Nolan Ryan. Pretty good matchup there, and Nolan wins that one. John Smiley not doing badly either. Watch this curveball against Ivan Rodriguez. Yeah, that's a strikeout. Say goodbye. No score after 12. Top of the 13th, two outs. Pedro Munoz at the plate. Kirby on base. Little flare there. Here comes Kirby. Here comes the throw. The Twins win, but it's much too late for them. And the two worst teams in the American League, Seattle and the Kansas City Royals. Ken Griffey on the run. Best center fielder in baseball. Ow! It goes. Brian McCrae goes two for the second time this season. Brian McCrae gets himself an inside-the-park home run, and for the second time in as many days, Kansas City beats the Mariners 3-0. It is, I believe, the 53rd time the Mariners have lost on the road this year, I think. Scoreboard now.
No sumo, no dune skiing, no frog squashing.
Don't start with that frog squashing thing yet. It is kind of upsetting when we don't have those little silly things at the end, but Tuesday is no-nonsense day in the world, and so nothing happens.
Oh, that must explain why no one's having fun. I understand.
Sports for this half hour.
Coming up next, a town meeting instead of a debate.
Not all that long ago, the federal government realized that pennies weren't worth making. The copper content was worth more than the coin. There was lots of talk about abandoning the penny altogether. In the end, the penny survived. Doesn't buy much of anything anymore, but there is still a place where you can use your pennies for something if you hurry. Here's Steve Hartman of ABC's New York station, WABC.
Getting around a town like Plainfield, New Jersey has gotten pretty expensive over the past 40 years. Consider the car is 8 times more expensive, the gasoline to run it 4 times more, and the place to park it, well, maybe Plainfield's a bad example. Because Plainfield is the only town around where they still have a penny parking meter. That's all this one takes.
Well, you got to put in the meter?
Yeah.
You got to put in there?
Penny.
Oh, shit, they need to be ashamed of themselves.
They should, and they are.
The pennies are way out of line.
David and Lou are public works people who admit they probably should have updated their meters long ago, but no one really saw the need. They weren't out to make money. Now they are, though. Not long ago, there were 40 penny parking meters around town, but over the past couple weeks, they've been slowly taking them out. Because the meters are so old and so outdated, they're now worth more money to the city off the streets than they are on. See, when word got out through some little newspaper articles, Plainfield started getting these letters. I would like to purchase. I'm interested in purchasing. I would definitely like to purchase. It seems those old meters are collector's items, so now they're locked away in the city garage while city council tries to figure out some way to auction them off. The penny meters are being replaced by nickel meters.
Okay, next.
Which, by all indications, is still a bargain, even in these parts.
Oh, it's only $0.05.
It's unlikely anyone will complain about the price increase, but it's still sad in a way. This was the last thing you could buy for a penny. Penny arcade games, penny stamps, penny candy, they're all gone.
Do you guys want to stay here and watch it tick down?
No.
Steve Hartman, Channel 7 Eyewitness News.
You know, that reminds me of a story back in 1969. I was living in a little town in Pennsylvania, and to park all day on the street cost you 50 cents, but the parking ticket cost a quarter.
Seriously?
Yeah. Connellsville, Pennsylvania.
Was that back when you used to ride the horse to school and bread only cost a penny a loaf? Was that back then?
I don't have to take this. That's the news for this half hour. I'll just say goodbye.
You're already awake. You may as well stay up for it. This is World News Now.